All right, you know how I've said in a few videos that I'm going to be building a Windows XP like era, like that sort of time, like games from that sort of time, machine with a Pentium 4 in it. And I said I had all the parts except for the case. Finally got the case. You may remember that case actually. This case is the case from my custom build computer from 2006. I've gutted the machine. This is the case from it. Let me just grab my chair. I gutted the machine. It's got nothing in it. It's just the case now. So I just unscrew it like these thumb screws. That's gonna fall down. It's empty. This used to have a seller on. This used to have a. This machine used to. This machine, the custom build computer from 2006 does not exist anymore because I've gutted it. I'm gonna use this case for my Pentium 4 gaming machine. Now, this is just a. Like, this is a. This computer, I'm just gonna answer a few questions that I know you're gonna ask in the comments. This computer is not going to be my main computer. It is absolutely not. No way. I mean, why the hell would I downgrade to a Pentium 4 when I already have a Core i5? Second, this computer is not gonna be playing games like not gonna be playing brand new games. It's gonna be playing. This computer is only gonna play games from 2002 to 2006. That's the time period that the games are gonna be on this machine. So any game from 2002 to 2006 will be played on this machine. Yeah, that's all I can think of. I've got all the parts, and yeah. So this case, it's a full-size ATX case, which is what I needed, because the motherboard I have is a full-size ATX board. You may be saying, "Oh, why don't you put it in this case, the AMD custom build?" Because this computer is a piece of crap. This case is only a micro ATX case, so the board wouldn't fit. It won't fit. I know it won't because it's a full-size ATX board. That's what it looks like. That's the board. We'll get to it later. But this case, I'm just gonna tour, do a tour around the case. We got four 5 1/4 inch drive bays. Two of them already had two optical drives in it. I've already taken them out, and I'll put some new ones in, which are better. We have a 3.5 inch bay for a floppy drive. Here we have a proper floppy drive slot, the slot loading floppy, if you will. So it looks like it blends in, which is good for cases, black cases mainly. So you can disguise a white floppy drive in it, which I've done before, and you can't even notice. We have the power button, reset, power and hard drive, power button, oh, there, power button, reset button, power LED, hard drive LED, and we have two USB 2.0 headphone and microphone jacks. I put the Pentium 4 sticker. Let me turn my camera's light on. I put the Pentium 4 sticker from the Pentium 4 custom build, the black one. That computer now is actually my sister's computer, because she had the custom build computer from 2006. She had this one when it was actually a system. I've gutted it basically. I've taken everything out, and yeah, it was a piece of crap. It wasn't barely working really. Well, the computer was working, but it was just running really crappy. I was pushing it by putting Windows 7. I know, I'm a mean brother for giving her a Celeron. I know. But she has the Pentium 4 custom built now, which has a her system now is a 3 GHz Pentium 4 hyper-threaded with a gigabyte of RAM, and that's all I've got. So and a 160 GB drive, and ATI Radeon 9600 XT graphics, and Windows 7 Ultimate. It actually runs it really well. And it's running Windows 7 Ultimate Service Pack 1, so, which is fully legit, fully legal. I'm not going to put Windows 8 on her machine. One, because the CPU doesn't have a physical address extension. And two, she thinks Windows 8's the biggest piece of crap in the world, because she's seen it. And, yeah. Decide nothing render. That's the panel with like a vent there. The back, we have standard power supply. Two, I think these are 80 mil fans. 80, I think they're 80 mil. I don't know. I don't know if they're 80 mil or not. Maybe either 80 mil or 92. I don't know. There's two of them there. We have the IO, place for where the IO is gonna go. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 full size expansion slots. So, yeah. The inside the case, we have a hard drive bays. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hard drive bays. Two floppy drive ones. I've already arranged the brass standoffs for the layout of the motherboard that I'm putting in. There's all your cables, which I'm gonna have to sort out. I'm gonna connect them to the motherboard off camera, since I have low vision, and I'll have to revert to the manual. It will probably take me a while to connect them all up, like the power switch connectors and everything, because I don't know the layout of the board. I'll probably have to get the. I actually do have the paper. I actually have the physical manual for it. So yeah, so that is a tour of the case. Now let's go over the parts. So yeah, okay. The parts we are going to use for this machine are all here. On this keyboard drawer from my desk, because my keyboard drawer is broken, and why is that turned off? Yes, I actually just touched the screen. Anyway, yeah, only a certain part of it works. I'm still reconfiguring that computer, because these are all the parts. Now, I put them on this keyboard drawer is because whoever puts computer parts on carpet is an absolute retard. I mean, seriously. You don't do that. You don't put computer parts on carpet because you can ruin them. So I put them on this bit of wood, which should be okay. Alright, so parts we have. A Western Digital Caviar SE 120GB IDE hard drive. It should be plenty for what I want to use it for. Just if you're run-of-the-mill floppy drive. Don't need to go into that. We have two fans. I think, yeah, the size, I think they're either 80 mil or 92 mil. I don't know. I might say, actually. I don't know. If someone can probably tell me if I'm missing it. If I'm missing that there because I can't read it, and so on, say something in the comments. Made in China. Yeah, it's a fan. I think they're either 80 or 92. I don't know. Here is the heatsink for the Socket 478 Intel Pentium 4. It is the copper core heatsink. So with the fan. So it's a stock one of the stock heatsink. That's all I need. Here is the chip, the CPU. It is an Intel Pentium 4. 3 GHz hyper-threaded. So, do not know if you can read it. It is scratched up a bit, but it is. I know the specs of it. It is a 3 GHz hyper-threaded Intel Pentium 4 with a 1 MB of level 2 cache and an 800 MHz frontside bus. That's what this motherboard supports. This motherboard actually supports every single Socket 478 chip, even the Pentium 4 Extreme Edition, but I don't have one of those. This is the best chip I have. Actually, I do have a 3.2 GHz CPU, but that CPU has problems in this motherboard. This motherboard doesn't like it. And that CPU, I also killed another motherboard with it, so. And yeah, I do have two of these Pentium 4 chips, these 3 GHz ones. I have a crap load of Socket 478 chips, which I don't need. The ones I need are LGA 775, because I want to replace the Celeron in that machine. But I don't have any. I've got Socket 478, but I don't have LGA 775. Here's the cables, you know, your IDE and floppy cables. Here's the memory. We have 1.5 GB of RAM. I wanted to get 2 GB, because this has dual channel memory. I want to put 2 gigs, but I don't have another 512 stick. I only have 3 512s. So I might put either 1.5 or 1.7 in it. So here it is, all DDR400. I won't be able to get dual channel because I only have 3 sticks, and that's a single-sided stick, whereas those are double-sided. It doesn't matter if they're the same brand, as long as they're the same speed, the same capacity, and the same amount of chips on each side. Like, say, if there's chips on this side and there's chips on the other side of the stick, it will work in dual channel. It doesn't matter, they don't have to be the exact same model. As long as they're the same capacity, same speed, and the amount of chips, like if they're double-sided or single-sided. So that's a single-sided chip, and those are double. So if I just put those in, that'd be dual channel. It's DDR400. So here's the optical drives. We have the, there's gonna be two of them because I don't have another panel for that slot. First one is a light-on DVD-ROM drive. Nothing special. Made in June 2005. Sorry. Just a light-on DVD-ROM drive. And yeah, IDE. So, of course, this motherboard does support SATA, but I'm not gonna put SATA on. The second optical drive is a light-on DVD rewritable drive. It is actually, these drives both match. They match each other because they're both. See, they match each other like they have the curved sort of style on the front. This top drive here is a bit yellowed compared. Oh, there's some there. Yeah, a bit of rust or something on the wheel. But they both have the volume wheel. That light actually lights up red when the drive is burning a disk, which is pretty cool. But they both have the same design on them, so both have the headphone jack. And yeah, they're both identical except that one's a burner, which is pretty cool. So I think it's an 8 times. I think it's an 8x burner. I don't know. But yeah, they're good drives. Here is the motherboard. We're gonna get to the motherboard last. We have a pow the power supply is a what is it? It's a 350 watt power supply. It's, you know, it's just a generic one. I do have a 430 watt what you call it? I forget the brand. I forget what the brand is, but it's a proper brand power supply. But that one has a lot of unnecessary cables, and it's not a modular power supply. It's got a lot of unnecessary cables that I don't need. So this power supply will just be fine. It's more than adequate, so it's good enough. Here's the sound cable for the optical drive. Here's an adapter for the motherboard, which has a FireWire port and 2 USB ports, and that connects to the motherboard. So, I have all the adapters and everything that this motherboard came with. It's actually an official Gigabyte adapter because it's a Gigabyte motherboard. So, here is a USB 1.1 card. I don't have a USB 2.0 card. Now, the reason I'm putting this in is because this motherboard, the USB ports on this motherboard are dead. Yep, the USB chipset on this motherboard is dead, from what I know. I've used this motherboard, and the USB is dead on it, so I have to use a USB card. Hopefully it might work again, because this motherboard's been sitting without a clock battery in it for months. So it might work again, I don't know. But this motherboard actually used to be my dad's board. I'll get to that last. Yes, that's a USB card. Here is a graphics card. This is an NVIDIA GeForce 6200 PCI. I don't have any AGP cards. I do have a Radeon 9600, but that video card actually doesn't work in Gigabyte boards. It only works in Asus boards. That ATI card has problems in Gigabyte motherboards. It just won't work correctly. But it works fine in Asus board. And what's my laptop doing? It's like turning itself on. But it's a 128 megabyte NVIDIA GeForce 6200. We have a DVI S video and VGA PCI, so it'll work. This motherboard doesn't have onboard video. There's the I/O port, and I think my laptop has to be plugged in. Yeah, I'll plug my laptop in because I don't want to die. All right, and last but not least, the motherboard. Here it is. This is a Gigabyte GA8IP1000 Pro 2. This motherboard back in 2004 was one of the best ones you could buy. It was. This back in the day, this would have been pretty good. My dad bought this brand new. He built a system with it. He built the system with that Pentium, with that 3 GHz Pentium 4 with 2 GB of RAM, and a 160 GB drive. That was back in 2004. So imagine back in 2004 having a system with a 3 GHz hyper-threaded Pentium 4, and 2 GB of memory, and a 160 GB drive. It may seem like a piece of crap now, but back then that was good. That was really, really good back then. And the graphics, I think, was a GeForce... I think it was a GeForce 4 or something like that. I think it was an MX440, 64 megs. The I.O. on the board, we have two PS2 ports, two USB, 2.0, which is dead. Serial, parallel, another serial, like two serial ports parallel, two more USB, Ethernet, I think it's gigabit Ethernet, I know it is, and the audio jacks, and my camera's automatic light is a retard. There's a socket for the CPU. We have dual channel memory, DDR400. So it's got the orange and purple slots. There's an IDE, there's your power, there's your floppy, there's the chipset. Which some of these motherboards I've actually seen the chipset heatsink actually has a fan. This one does not. This one doesn't have the fan, but still. It uses the Intel 865PE chipset. Here's the AGP 8X slot, your PCI slots, how many you got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's your clock battery, and there's... this motherboard also has dual BIOS on it. It has dual BIOS chips. So basically, if you screw up, if you like trying to flash your BIOS, and you screw up the flashing of the BIOS, this computer has a backup one. So it has two BIOSes, dual BIOS, Basically, that was kick-ass back in the day. Because some computers still don't even... some motherboards, you'd be lucky to have that today. Today, some motherboards don't even have that. So back then, that was a luxury. I mean, a real luxury. As a Southbridge, two SATA. There's a USB connections, as a FireWire. And there's an audio connector for optical audio. I actually have the optical audio adapter, but I'm not going to put it in. I do have the optical audio adapter, which goes in that red connector there. And my email's going off. You got your capacitors. None of the capacitors look blown, which is a good thing. I've looked at the capacitors already. None of them look blown. So the only thing that's really wrong with this board is the USB chipset is dead. And then the RAM. There can be problems with the RAM as well. The RAM... this motherboard's very picky with memory. you will not believe my frustration with this motherboard's RAM. The RAM that I put in this board, it's very picky with it. So, I don't know if it'll work correctly with that RAM. I might have to, some sticks will work in some slots, and then they won't work in others. So it'll probably take me a while to get, hopefully it just works when I put it in, which is what I want. I've never actually had a build. I've never built a computer. I've built a computer, obviously. I've built a million times. But I've never built one where I've just put everything together in the first time and actually had it work correctly the first time. I've always had to muck around trying to get it to work correctly. Every time I've built a machine, I've never gotten it to work the first time. So hopefully I can this time. So enough rambling. Let's go on to the build. So... Yeah.